Let us talk about networking topologies. Now, what are they? They define the arrangement of various elements like links and nodes of a computer network. It may be depicted physically or logically, and a physical topology is also known as a network topology, and it tells us how nodes are connected actually through the physical links, whereas logical topology tells us how data is moved through the network and is bound to network protocols. An example of this includes that Ethernet is a logical bus topology but also a physical star topology. Moving on to types of networking topology, first we have point-to-point topology. It is the simplest topology with a dedicated link between two endpoints. They are the basic models of telephony, and it is of two types, permanent or dedicated point-to-point topology, where the link is permanently associated with the two endpoints, and a tin can telephone is its example. We can also have a switched point-to-point topology, and it uses packet switching and circuit switching technology where the point-to-point circuit can be dynamically set up and dropped whenever needed, and it is the basic model of traditional telephony. Next, we have the bus topology, and in a bus topology, the nodes are directly connected to a common half-duplex link called a bus, and they are of two types, the linear bus topology where the common communication link has exactly two endpoints, and the distributed bus topology, where the common communication link can have many endpoints resulting from branching. We also have the star topology, and it consists of one central hub switch or computer that transmits messages. This configuration is most common with twisted pair cables, however, coaxial or fiber optic cables can also be used. Its type are the extended star topology, where the central device is connected to some repeaters, which are in turn connected to the nodes, or it can be a distributed star topology, where different networks are connected to each other, sometimes with no central point, and this can also be placed under hybrid topology. Next coming up is the ring topology, where the data travels around a link in one direction and each device on the ring acts as a repeater to keep the signal strong as it travels. Every node is a critical link and no central server is present, and all the nodes work as servers and repeaters. We also have the mesh topology, where each and every node is connected to every other node. Earlier, it was only a theoretical topology, but today, due to wireless communication, it has become a reality. It's of two types, that is fully connected or partially connected. And in fully connected mesh topology, it does not need switching or broadcasting. And by the formula, C is equal to N multiplied by N minus 1 by 2. This defines the total connections required in this network, where C is the total connection and N is the number of nodes. Now, tree topology is essentially a combination of bus and star topology, and is both the disadvantages of bus topology and the advantages of star topology. Finally, we have the hybrid topology, which can be a mixture of any type of topology we have discussed earlier. To end this video, we'll discuss some of the topology jargons. First, we have the bus. It is the common communication link in a bus networking topology and acts as a backbone for the network. And a host on a bus network is called a workstation. WAP or wireless access points are the central hubs in a wireless star topologies, and wireless fully connected mesh networks are also called ad hoc networks.